There are over 600 software companies that form Washington's mini Silicon Valley, anchored by the largest independent software firm in the world, the Microsoft Corporation. The corporate grounds look like a college campus, and the employees rather like grad students. But behind this laid-back exterior lies a driven team of programmers and software specialists responsible for creating Microsoft's product line. Bottom line this year, $800 million.
I think we attract people that normally wouldn't think of going into industry, because it doesn't feel like you're in industry. It feels like you're just doing great creative work. In our own limited way, we get to change the world. And you get to really affect the way people work, make them more productive. That's a very exciting thing.
Bill Gates is the chairman and chief executive officer, co-founder of Microsoft, and a billionaire at the age of 33. And good morning. Thank you for being with us today. Would you hire many people 33 years old, a little old for your industry?
Well, we'll hire people at any age as long as they're super energetic and they want to make personal computers easier to use. But we end up hiring mostly people right out of college or business school.
And they don't need a lot of training. They are ready to be brilliant from the word go?
No, they need to be smart before they come in. And we give them a lot of training on the job. We put them right to work. But no, we don't expect that they know a lot about it before they get there.
Is there a connection between creativity and the natural beauty of Seattle? Is that why you're here?
Well, not really. I grew up in Seattle. So as soon as my company had over 20 people, I decided to move it back here. And it was sort of a decision of whether to be down in California, in Silicon Valley, where a lot of things happen. But the rumor mill makes it hard to keep secrets and employees switch from company to company, or being up here where we're able to keep our secrets and you know, be really on our own. It's been fantastic to be here. I mean, Seattle's a great place. When it's rainy, people work hard. When it's nice, there's lots of things for people to do.
You are a very rare and potent combination. You are a brilliant computer programmer, and you are a savvy businessman. You don't get to be a billionaire otherwise. That is an extremely rare combination, isn't it? Will you grant that? Otherwise, there'd be more billionaires, wouldn't there?
I find both parts of the business fun, and there aren't that many people who get involved in both.
You have always been more intrigued by the practical applications. When will your definition of practical mesh with my definition of practical?
Well, we're continually trying to make the computers easier to use. I mean, the idea is that eventually everyone will use a computer as a very important tool, whether it's learning or on their desk or even at home.
We already do at NBC.
Right, yeah. Right. But as an individual, you probably don't sit down and learn the commands yourself or view that as the way that you would learn something or find something out.
Well, tell me what CD-ROM is.
Well, today when you use a computer, a lot of it's just typing documents or dealing with numbers. And if you wanted to learn about geography or you wanted to learn about medicine or even select a movie to see, you wouldn't use a computer to do that. You'd use a catalog or something like that. With a CD, which is the same plastic disc that you use to hold high-quality music, we can actually put images and sound together with computer programs.
Give me an example. If I looked up something in the encyclopedia, say, about Seattle.
Well, we can put an entire encyclopedia on one of these discs. And when you look up Seattle, instead of just seeing a bunch of text, you would see a little movie. In fact, you could have a little diagram of Seattle, and you could point to any part of that map and immediately see pictures of that part of the city. Yeah. You could also see a timeline, and then you could zoom in on various events in the city's history.
I think it's interesting. Call a man a billionaire and he doesn't flinch. Ask him to tell me about one of his products, CD-ROM. You've really engaged. Bill Gates, thank you.